There's an app called Clover that's not the dating app. It looks nice, it functions nice, but is it better than Notion? Half the time I feel like all these apps could be better than Notion. I just act like they're not because I'm Notion guy.
So jumping right into Clover, we can see that there's a free version which has up to 1,000 blocks, 50 megabytes of uploads, up to 3 guests, and you have title search. However, with the pro version, if you go for the monthly, it's a little bit more expensive, but from the annual standpoint, if you're at an introductory rate, you can actually get it for $6 a month, which is not too bad. You get inboxes and labels, full text search across various pages, and unlimited blocks, uploads, and guests. Jumping right into what Clover has, as you can see in the page tree here, you actually have documents, surfaces, folders, and then there's a template option. So if we go here, we can see the different things that there are here. And for example, we would have different surfaces that could be used as templates, and then documents. So we can dive into a document template really quick. So this is just an example one-on-one, but this application has basic markdown functionality. So there is actually something very similar to Notion where you can have something like a /2 to-do list. This is an example. And if you press enter under that and indent it, it would do the same indent functionality, and then shift tab would unindent it as well. And then if you go to the right of something like this, you can actually assign a date to it. So I would be able to actually have this exact block itself be assigned to specific dates. So if we were to go more in this markdown functionality, you can see that there is /lists, numbered lists, callouts, and this callout is different than a Notion one because it doesn't have that same type of functionality regarding the emoji that comes with it. And if you click on the left here, you can see that there's a delete option and a copy link to the specific block. Now on the left, we have a little bit of a table of contents that's associated with the different text here. So this is an H1, right? So this guy, if I did another H1, interrupt that list. But then if we go over here, we can see that this is that over here. Now, if we double click on one of these, we can change what this is. So if I were to double click on this callout, I could change it to an H1 or an H2 checklist and all this different functionality. It doesn't have that side functionality that Notion has, but it has that. There's also code blocks. And what's intriguing is that schedule and that how you can assign it to specific dates. Now, I will say that this is an application that is mainly a note-taking and drawing application. So it has that functionality that Notion doesn't have regarding the drawing. However, there is no databases or anything like that, but there are integrations with it that Notion doesn't have. So when you start with Clover, you can actually have an integration with your Google Calendar. And then in the top right, I could actually have my example Google Calendar stuff come through. So I could have an example calendar for video so that I don't have anything personal come up. So as you can see, it shows that what your daily schedule is in this daily note section. That's a very nice basic integration so that when you have this section that you just want to do some basic notes jotting down, it's nice here. So what that date functionality shows you is the fact that if I move these to today, this would actually have these go back in there. But if I press Control Z and undid those, what you'll see is that anything in your notes that you assign to specific days, if you go to the daily notes section, it would be there. This is due tomorrow, and I actually could take this functionality and press this, it would change it to tomorrow, but this changes the move to in general, but this is a nice little button to move it to tomorrow. If I go to Monday, the 28th, you'll see that it moves that day. So if I were to change this to March 3rd, and I move to March 3rd, this would have a nice little functionality. This is a nice little hub just of a basic to-do list and notes that you were to have, and you can scroll through your entire calendar in that format. As can be seen in the settings, what's interesting is you can actually do a Control Alt and then slash here, and that will bring up a global quick note shortcut. So I can add text to today or a different task for today. This task, and you can add it to today. And if we go back to the daily notes, you'll see that this task is here. Now, as well as some settings that you have that are interesting is that you can go and change your theme to light or dark mode. And then you can actually change the shade of that sidebar to be a little bit brighter or darker, depending on what you want. And then also the highlight color that you want can be different. So as you can see with the different functionality that we have here, this blue could be what you want. But if I go back into the theme here, say I wanted it to be something else, I could have it be purple, blue, green. If we go back in here, you'll see it's whatever color this is. Colorblind guy, jokes. So what's very interesting about this is the fact that this doesn't have individual task databases by any means, but it has a bunch of different pages that when used together can be a task management system, because if I press these two brackets and press space, that becomes a part of it, and you can assign this to its overall database. And then this example can actually be backlinked to, if I do bracket, bracket, and then I could connect it to another page. So for example, let's make a new page here. Make a new document. New document example. Let's take this is a task for --, one-on-one with name. And then I could assign it to tomorrow. So this has basic links with it as well, which is pretty nice and interesting to use. But what's different with this application that overall makes it just a nice change of pace from Notion is the fact that you can draw in it and it has actual functionality in this sense. So we could obviously look at the different templates that were there. So if we go here to a new from template, we can see that we can mind map in here, which is pretty nice overall. So there's a different text functionality. I can add a little text box here and be like, this is more of an explanation for what this is doing here. And you can see this is already some examples. There's some line functionality that works here. I could just draw a straight line, draw an angled line to block that off again. We can input photos in here and attach them to the page. So if I took an example one here of a thumbnail, like the one for this video, we can actually showcase this. So I'll cover this over there. And we could take this one here and we could do some drawings on top of it that would be different. You can add captions to different pictures. So this could be a caption for this amazing thumbnail. And then there is not much text functionality when it comes to editing this. However, what you can do is change the backdrop of this, which has a little outline backdrop for it. You can do not a crazy amount of stuff with this, but you can lock things in place so that they're stuck on the image. You can then unlock it and then have the option to move things from the back to the front, just like you could in Canva. So this is a nice visualization tool as well, so that you can do things like add emojis. So smile, I could do a smile emoji and put this over my face. And then you could change the color on this to be whatever you want here. So let's do a little yellow smiley face. Then this is just like any other whiteboard where you can obviously pan around and make this larger, smaller. So there are also as a pencil tool that has multiple different coloring options with different thicknesses, with a bunch of different colors. You could have different frames and shapes put on here as well. So this is the different shape options that you had. So a little triangle, Illuminati confirmed, Dimitri's Illuminati, so I can move to back and then you wouldn't see this, but if I press Control Z, it would come back. And then I can move this to the side quickly and move this guy to the front and then it would be in front of it. So take a little red face. And then there's something called grids here so that you could, or frames here, so that you could only see certain sections. Okay, so this would be picture only. So if I were to take this guy, it actually could only have it showcase certain parts of the page. So what I'll do here is press picture only and then it'll actually showcase just what's on that frame. And then you have the option to do things like favorite this page, label it with a different label. So pictures of me. And then there's the option to enter a presentation mode and show presentations in this. And then there's actually the option to move this to different pages as well. I can go on this mind map and I can press Control Shift M and move this anywhere I'd want. So I can actually go to the one-on-one with name. And you can see now it's a sub page of that as well. And it's in the frame view right now. If I zoom out, you can see that there is the entirety of this picture and side view as well. And if we press on the bottom right here, you actually have the ability to like toggle throughout the entire minimap. So this is actually a little bit nicer than what ClickUp currently has for its whiteboards, because I kind of like the fact that you can zoom out like that. ClickUp's a little bit behind when it comes to this, I would say. And the inbox section is a nice organizational place as well for things. So it has what's going on in regards to what's been made today. So the inbox for me, as you can see, all this stuff is created today in comparison to what's old over here. So it's just stuff that's currently coming in. And another fun feature about this product is if you right click on the side here, you actually have the option to change what the menu looks like. So I can get rid of the inbox. I could get rid of all pages. I can get rid of the labels, page tree, and all these different side things here. I just have the option to change how this looks however I want it to. I could press Control Alt Backslash, just like it shows there. And I could actually do a new folder here, which would take multiple of these pages. So if I press this guy, it actually has the option to have an emoji. So I could have a little smiley guy here and then new example pages. And I could drag these to all go within the folder as well. So if I put this guy on top here, it would all be in the folder and I could toggle this open and closed.
If you guys like this video and want to see more videos on how to improve your productivity, click the end card right there.